Is anyone else wondering whether the government are suffering from collective whiplash after their sudden and very abrupt U-turn regarding immigration and the messaging around it? Because I certainly am. In case you missed it, up until very recently, and by that I mean late October, anyone saying that Ireland should implement caps on immigration, or that we were spending too much on accommodating migrants, or, dare I say it, that Ireland was full, would be dismissed by the government and a willing media as either being racist, far-right, or both. Any other questioning of Ireland's immigration policy was met with similar, and yet, all of a sudden, our government now seemed to be spouting this very same far-right rhetoric. So what has changed, and what are they actually saying? Well, it all started with Ukrainian temporary protection applicants. The government, well, Fine Gael and the Greens, but more on that later, decided very abruptly that we need to change our approach to the numbers of Ukrainians arriving into Ireland each week, and how we accommodate them. This shift in ideology started when plans were announced to impose a time limit on state accommodation for newly arrived Ukrainians. Under new proposals, new arrivals from Ukraine would only be offered state accommodation for 3 months before they would have to find their own private rental property or take a pledged property through the Offer a Home scheme. The costs involved in providing the accommodation and the sheer volume of new arrivals would appear to be the impetus for the new policy approach. We are now seeing up to 200 Ukrainians arriving every day, and the cost of accommodating them is now standing at 1.5 billion euro a year. Anyone can see that this is unsustainable, and now, it appears, so can the government. The rhetoric from government didn't stop there, however, as Leo Varadkar went on to say that the state's approach to accommodating refugees and asylum seekers in general must change, as we are at the limits of our capacity. Now that is certainly a huge shift in policy and ideology from our government, isn't it? All of a sudden, our Taoiseach is telling us that Ireland is full? Well, no, he said at capacity, didn't he? But that's just the double plus good acceptable newspeak way of saying Ireland is full though, isn't it? The more palatable way, with less racist and far-right connotations. Or something. But Varadkar didn't stop there. He went on to admit that many Ukrainians have been living in other European countries before deciding to come to Ireland. 30% of those coming from Ukraine have spent quite some time in another EU country, in fact. And our government have even worked out why. Because we offer a far better package of supports than other countries, and so we are attracting a lot more. In fact, Ireland has taken in more Ukrainian refugees per head of population than the UK and major EU nations. We have only taken in less than that of 6 Eastern European countries. Now, I know we are a generous country, and to be honest, I think that's something the world needs more of. If more countries were as generous as Ireland, the world might be a better place all around. But that's idealistic thinking. The world is not that generous, as evidenced by the response of other countries. So we can't continue to be an outlier here. We can't continue on this unsustainable path of being the shelter for the rest of the displaced world. We just do not have the resources. Our health service, despite being one of the best funded in the world, is on its knees. Adding more demand will not help matters. Our schools are oversubscribed and under-resourced with ridiculously high student-to-teacher ratios. More demand will not help here either. Our housing and rental sectors are the root of the majority of our troubles here in Ireland. The demand is through the roof, while the supply is virtually non-existent and extortionate. Again, adding more demand only serves to exacerbate these issues. Now, all of these issues are not caused by refugees or asylum seekers in and of themselves, but they are certainly exacerbated by the sheer volume of immigration we are seeing. And that, again, comes back to our government and their policies. And again, it would appear that the government themselves are now awake to the realities of this situation. So why the sudden change in tactic then? What has changed so drastically for the sudden and abrupt change in rhetoric when accepting so many migrants has been a pillar of government policy for so long, even in the face of public opposition? Have they finally seen the light that this is simply unsustainable? Have they finally seen what 75% of people could see back in May, that we are taking in too many refugees? Or is that giving them too much credit? After all, that poll is months old and the government government didn't address those concerns then, did they? No, I think the change in rhetoric is far simpler to explain. This coalition government is finally starting to realise that they are running out of road, that the patience of the electorate is wearing thinner and thinner by the day. People are sick of the hypocrisy and one-track mind of the Greens. They are sick of the return of Bertie-like politics of Fianna Fáil, whereby alleged corruption is just swept under the rug, while pockets are filled, and the ineffectual and failing ministers among their ranks. They are sick of Fine Gael and their egos, and self-serving and out-of-touch policies. The evidence of this is borne out in each successive opinion poll. Sinn Féin haven't had to do much at all to consolidate their position at the top, while the coalition parties slip and stumble, struggling to make any real gains at all, no matter what they attempt to win people over. The recent budget is a case in point, another so-called giveaway budget, where they threw around once-off payments again in the hopes of gaining a budget bounce. But it was evident after budget day came and went that any bounce would be minimal. People want sustainable solutions, not one-off bandages. There was absolutely nothing in the budget to actually address the cost of living, and not a single change to their failing housing policy. And no, the renter's tax credit is nothing useful there, as quite a lot of renters won't claim it for fear of a spotlight being shone on their unregistered landlord, which would put their tenancy in a precarious situation. So a nothing budget would no real help for anyone, and no real budget bounce for the coalition parties either. They must have known it was coming, because that, in my view, is why they decided to finally turn to the low-hanging fruit of immigration. They know from the results of that poll in May that 75% of people believe we are taking in too many refugees, and while polls are not always perfectly accurate, 75% is a figure that can't just be ignored. They know that the protests were not chock full of far-right racists. I mean, there were some in attendance, sure, but they know that the vast majority of protesters were just ordinary people worried about the impact an influx of migrants would have on their communities. As I mentioned in my last video on this topic, refugees are predominantly being housed in either working class or rural areas, where local resources are already at breaking point, and more people added in such large numbers will only serve to put even more strain on those resources. So yeah, it seems to me that the government must think this is a topic that they can use to try and win back the public, to show that they've listened, and that they understand the concerns at last. They know that a high percentage of people are not on board with the current immigration policy, so they finally pulled the trigger on acting on it in the hopes that the electorate will thank them. It's nothing more than a cynical ploy to win over voters, in my view. What makes me think it's just a ploy? Well, aside from the abrupt U-turn, it's the argument between Micheál Martin and Roderick O'Gorman over the proposals and the fallout from that spat. So it would appear that this 90-day time limit proposal is more of a Fine Gael Green initiative, as while Micheál Martin commented on what he called the phenomenon of Ukrainians arriving in Ireland having lived elsewhere in Europe, it doesn't seem to me like Fianna Fáil wanted much more than a crackdown on that side of things. Martin was not very happy with the proposals, with reports ranging from a heated discussion to a full-on row between himself and O'Gorman. And why? Well, not because he was truly worried about the Ukrainians at the heart of this issue, no, he was more worried about how bad this move to limit state-offered accommodation would make Fianna Fáil and his Minister for Homelessness, Dara O'Brien, look when the 90 days are up and these people have to fend for themselves in a broken rental market, thus driving up demand and the inevitable increase in those accessing emergency accommodation and homeless figures that will follow. And while we're on the subject, a government spokesperson claimed that Ukrainians won't have any rights to housing supports once the 90 days are up, and the willing media just swallowed it and printed it without a second thought. So what, they'll just disappear then, will they? You know, when they have to enter the broken rental market that the rest of us have to deal with. They'll be turned away from emergency accommodation and homeless services, yeah? Yeah, bloody right. They're here, and the government are playing silly beggars if they think they can pull the wool over people's eyes and pretend that they won't help these people after taking them in the first place. Of course they will, and we all know it. It would be really helpful if we had a media that questioned these statements from the nameless spokespeople. Now, in my view, this whole thing stinks of self-preservation from all sides. While the messaging from Fine Gael and the Greens certainly seems like they are trying to win back voters who disagree with their immigration policies, it all just rings hollow to me. What will fundamentally change if this proposal is brought in? While Varadkar spoke in broad terms about refugees and asylum seekers, these proposals will only affect new Ukrainian arrivals, even though he spoke about concerns surrounding accommodation for all refugees. So why is this the only proposal? Why are we not looking at caps on immigration across the board then if we are, as Varadkar put it, at capacity? Because this is merely a hollow showing to try and win back some voters in my view, and nothing more. More pointless soundbites and kite flying propped up by the bare minimum and ineffective policy in the vain hopes of winning over the public. As for Fianna Fáil, well, they're only worried about the optics. Everyone and their granny can see that they have failed catastrophically on housing, and not just in this iteration of government, I might add. So hearing Michael McGrath come out and say how worried he is about these new proposals and the strain it may put on renters as demand in the rental market increases when the 90 days are up just sickens me. His party have done absolutely nothing to actually address the housing and rental issues in this country. They and their coalition partners are the reasons couples like my husband and I worry about what the future holds for ourselves and our children. They are the reason families like my own are facing the reality of never having the security of home ownership that older generations had. They are the reason families like my own have zero security when it comes to a roof over our heads. I mean, they won't even ban no-fault evictions, for fuck's sake. A basic, simple thing that they could do to help the good tenants of Ireland, and they can't be arsed because, God forbid, they put renters ahead of landlords and the golden goose. They haven't taxed vacant properties to high heaven, and they've allowed vulture funds to run amok. And through their immigration policies, they have allowed more and more demand to build up while delivering next to nothing in affordable or social housing. And yet here they are pretending they care about renters. Fuck right off with that bullshit, Michael. You and your party couldn't give a flying fuck about renters, so let's call a spade here. Fianna Fáil are only worried about how much worse the Department of Housing will look when even more demand lands on their doorstep. That's it. Nothing more, nothing less. Self-preservation. That's all this whole exercise is. Because all I'm seeing is that Fine Gael and the Greens want to jump headlong into trying to tap into the public sentiment over immigration to help their own cause while doing as little as possible. While Fianna Fáil are rallying against it because it'll make their housing failures look even worse. I mean, that's it in a nutshell, isn't it? All three parties don't actually give a shite about refugees or asylum seekers. Their approach has been quite lucrative for the wealthy here in Ireland, and the coalition get to look like the best in the class on the world stage. And now that public opinion is turning, they're happy to change up their stance for political gain. And all three parties certainly don't give a shite about the Irish electorate either. If they did, they wouldn't have invited such high levels of demand onto already creaking resources at the expense of Irish people. This is a kite-flying exercise and nothing more, with the only real item of note being the discord between the coalition parties as they all try to fumble their way towards more votes in their own selfish ways. So what do you think? Am I too cynical? Are Fine Gael and the Greens serious about stemming the tide of immigration here? Are Fianna Fáil truly worried about the refugees? Or is it all just cynical self-preservation in action from all sides? Are the cracks finally starting to form as each party seeks to distance themselves from who they perceive to be the real failures in this coalition? Could this be the start of the long goodbye for this government?
Well, we live in hope.
Can I finally stop hearing that I'm ignoring immigration after this second full video dedicated to the topic? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to be notified of new content. If you want to support the channel, you can buy me a coffee or a super thanks, which is greatly appreciated, and a huge thank you to those of you that already have. You can also follow me on Twitter. Until next time, slán go fóill.